This morning, Mr. President, the New York Times reported that Mick Mulvaney, the head of the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, that's the bureau that saved $12 billion for 12 million American consumers who have been wronged, cheated, misled, deceived by banks and other financial service actors. $12 billion, 29 million consumers helped. That's what the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau is. Now, put that in, think about that for a second. This morning, the New York Times reported that Mick Mulvaney, the head of that bureau, the organization that looks out, or at least used to look out for American bank customers, he made a speech to 1,300 bankers yesterday. And he told the banking industry to step up their lobbying efforts. So you've got it. You've got a government official who takes an oath to represent the American public to the best of his ability and to carry out his job to the best of his ability, the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau. He is going in front of bankers in telling them to step up their lobbying efforts to weaken the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau. The Times reports this, quote, and there is a recording of this, so this isn't as probably Mr. Mulvaney might suggest, or the president will suggest, or somebody, this isn't fake news. This is a recording, a real recording. He told banking industry executives on Tuesday that they should press lawmakers hard to pursue their agenda. And he revealed that as a congressman, he'd meet only with lobbyists if they had contributed to his campaign. Here's what he said. This is the director of the Consumer Bureau, Mr. President. We had a hierarchy in my, he was a member of Congress, a far-right Tea Party Republican member of Congress who took a lot of bank contributions, I would add, but put that aside for a moment, till he became the head of the Office of Management Budget and then the Consumer Bureau. He said, we had a hierarchy in my office in Congress. That's, Mr. President, when he served down the hall here, the other end of the Capitol in the U.S. Congress. We had a hierarchy in my office in Congress, he told 1,300 bankers and lending industry officials at the American Bankers Conference in Washington, said, we had a hierarchy in my office in Congress. If you're a lobbyist who never gave us money, I didn't talk to you. If you're a lobbyist who gave us money, I might talk to you. I guess you can't call that bribery. I'm not suggesting exactly it's bribery, but you're saying if you didn't give me money, I wouldn't talk to you. If you gave me money, maybe I'll talk to you. I'm not a lawyer. I don't think that's under the classification of bribery, but I think it's pretty awful. It's pretty awful when the guy that appointed you that said he's going to clear the swamp. It's pretty awful when you face you've been elected by the people, in his case of South Carolina, and you say, if they didn't give me money, I wouldn't talk to you. If you gave me money, maybe I'll talk to you. I mean, it really is. Can you believe that? That this is a high-ranked U.S. government official that was confirmed by the U.S. Senate, at least for the first job at Office of Management Budget. Deciding whom you will meet with based on campaign contributions is the kind of pay-to-play that makes Americans furious with Washington, D.C. I mean, President Trump got elected because he was going to drain the swamp. President Trump got elected because he said the system was rigged. President Trump got elected because he doesn't want this pay-to-play. President Trump got elected because this place needs cleaned out. Well, so you appoint somebody to head of the underlying Consumer Financial Protection Bureau who only really wants to talk to you if you gave him campaign money. That's fundamentally what he's saying. If the policy from his congressional office has been his policy at OMB and his policy at the Consumer Bureau, it's corrupted all of his work. It's hard to believe anything otherwise. Mr. Mulvaney should resign, Mr. President. He should resign. He should release his schedule since he's been head of the Consumer Bureau. You know, one of the functions of the U.S. Senate, of either party, regardless of the president, is to oversee what exactly is happening in the executive branch of government. And I think it's important that we see Mr. Mulvaney's schedule. Who's he meeting with? What kind of contributions did they make to him when he was a congressman? Is he directing money to the Senate majority or to the House majority members to help Speaker Ryan? Is he sending money to political candidates that have been his allies in trying to emasculate the Consumer Protection Bureau? So Mr. Mulvaney should resign. He should release the schedule in the White House. The White House should quickly nominate a permanent CFPB director, a permanent consumer director with bipartisan support, and, may I suggest, a moral compass. I'll say that again. The White House should quickly nominate a permanent director of the Consumer Bureau with bipartisan support and a moral compass. Banks and payday lenders already have armies of lobbyists on their side. Mr. President, they don't need one more. I yield the floor.